guys, how's it going? This is Asreen. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to scrape a massive list of websites using n8n and Zenrose to be able to do amazing things. Now, this is part of a bigger series where we're going to show you guys how to do AI personalized outreach at scale so you guys can get more leads for your business. But without further ado, let's go ahead and jump right in. Now, before we get started, there is a couple of things I want to make sure that you guys have in place to make sure you can follow this tutorial correctly. Number one is you guys are going to need access to n8n. Number two, you guys are going to need a Zenrose account. Now, it's okay if you use the free trial account. You're only going to be limited to, I believe, 1,000 website scrapes, but still, that's pretty good for a free trial, right? Number three, you're going to need a list of websites to scrape. Now, I grabbed my list off of Apollo, and then I cleaned it using Rion. I will be showing how to do that in this video as well, so that you guys understand that process. But essentially, you can grab lists from anywhere to scrape any type of website for whatever reason you want. Number four, you're going to need access to Google Sheets. And number five, and this one is optional, a master database where you keep all your contacts in if you're doing for outbound generation. Now, if you guys don't have a master database, it's totally fine. It's not needed, but I will be showing you guys how to make one in a future video so you can keep everything organized and spickety span. All right, let's jump into it. All right, so the first step here is we're going to clean out the list of the emails. Now, what we're doing here is we're removing all the bouncing emails and all the emails that might go to the wrong person, right? I don't want to be spending AI credits, spending time scraping, sending emails to a list that is low quality. It doesn't make any sense. It could break my email accounts. So I'm going to clean it first using Rion. And for those of you who don't know, there is a lifetime deal of Rion on AppSumo. I'm not affiliated with them. It's just a really good product. You can grab it and have unlimited, well, not unlimited, but like a daily amount of credits you can use to clean your emails. So I'm literally just going to choose file here. Bam, we're going to show all files. I'm going to go to my leads and we're going to grab a list of all warehouses in the US, all the C-level and up people, and we're just going to hit start verification and we're going to wait until this is done. All right, now that the task is done, what we're going to do is we're going to download all of the clean results right here, save to include results as a CSV. All right, then what we're going to do is we're going to upload it into Google Sheets. So we're going to drop a new sheet, import, upload, browse, and just the last one. Give it a sec. I'm just going to replace it. And I'm going to call this sheet warehouses. But not there, right? So Control Z, we're going to do it there. Warehouses. Awesome. Now that it's in Google Sheets, we're going to jump over to our n8n flow. Now, this is a self-hosted n8n instance. I have another video on how to do that, and I'll be updating it with an even better version here soon. That being said, this is what we're trying to build today. I'm going to run through all the nodes real quick, and then we'll jump in and actually set it up and start it up. Now, just so you guys know, this is a quick side note. I am splitting this into multiple flows, and the reason why is because I would like them to run asynchronously to finish the tasks quicker. And also, sometimes there are memory issues when it comes to running large flows on really, really large lists. And to prevent these memory issues, I split a really, really big flow into a bunch of smaller flows, which also helps me chunk down this content for you guys. So the first node here is we just click and it'll grab all the results from this Google spreadsheet, right? And then it's going to batch it. Now I'm doing batches of three, okay? The reason why three is because Zenrose has rate limits and we don't want to hit those rate limits. So I noticed that three doesn't seem to have any problems. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to test to see if they have a website and an email. If they're missing the email or they're missing the website, I don't even want them in my database, right? After that, I'm going to check to see if they're part of my master database. You guys don't have to do that. You can totally skip this step. But I'll show you in a little bit more detail how to do this in a bit. Here, I'm just checking to see if it exists. So those two nodes, we'll check if it exists. If it already exists in my database, why would I add it twice? So we'll just go to the next item, right? Then we actually start the scraping here. We're going to extract and clean the HTML. We're going to double check that it's good data. If it's good data, we're going to map it into fields. We're going to clean it for the database, and we're going to send it back to Superbase, which is where my master database is held. That being said, if you're not using a master database, you could actually just skip these three sections and just go straight to a Google Sheets node. So the next step, I'm actually going to set this up and run this with you guys. So setting up Google Sheets with Inaden is kind of a pain in the ass. So I thought I would run through the process with you guys so that you guys can see what that looks like. So we're going to put a Google Sheets node here. All right. And we're going to click here, create new credential. Here's my callback URL. I'm going to need this, right? What I need to do is I need to go to console.cloud.google.com/welcome. We're going to make a new project. I'm going to call this test for YouTube. All right. Organization is fine. Whatever. Let's create it. It just created a new one. All right, now that the project's created, just make sure that you're up here and you selected the new project test for YouTube, okay? Now we're gonna go to APIs and services, and we're going to type in Sheets at the top, and we're gonna go to Google Sheets API, okay? Then what we're going to do is we're gonna enable this baby. Okay, now it's created. In order to do it, we have to do the OAuth consent screen and the credentials. So first we'll go to OAuth consent screen. And we're going to go internal. We're not using it for external. We're going to put a name, YouTube test. We're going to put an email, whatever email, it's fine. I don't need a logo or domain. We have to put beast.horizon.dev with HTTPS. That's my Inaden URL. Just so you guys know. And we're going to put it here as well. I believe horizon.dev. Yeah. And I think beast.horizon.dev. Okay. Yeah, it's got to be top level. So horizon.dev. Cool. Save and continue. Oh, and then email address. horizon-development.com. Go ahead and email me anytime if you guys want. I will answer, but it might take me a while. There you go. Scopes. I don't believe we need to add. Oh, yeah. Sheets API. Check all this. Just click update. It's fine. Save and continue. And that's done. Now we have to go to credentials. Feel free to steal these. I'm going to delete this project here soon anyway, so it's fine. Create credentials. We're going to go OAuth client ID. Application type, web app. Authorized redirect URLs. Now, this is where we get this URL here from Inaden, right? We're going to paste that buddy there, and we're going to hit create. Bam. And then we get this client ID, this client secret. So let's copy that. Go over here, client ID. We'll go back, copy this. Go over here, client secret. Bam. We'll sign in with Google real quick. I don't know which account I'm using. I believe I'm using this one. Allow. Got connected. The window will be closed now. Now, this is really weird. I've noticed this happen sometimes where it doesn't quite say it's connected. So you go out of the screen, you click close, and then you edit it again and it's connected. It's just a little bug on Inaden. Don't really have to worry about it. It is connected though. You can now see. All right. Now that we've hooked up Google Sheets, now we're going to make sure we choose the right spreadsheet. So I'm going to choose warehouses from the list and just grab that sheet. That's it for that. Now we're going to go through the flow and make sure everything works. So as I said, we're going to loop through the items in batch sizes of 3. Then what we're going to do is we're going to check to see if there's a website and if there's an email, okay? After that's done, we're going to go to the database. Some people can skip this step. What we're going to do is we're going to select one from my master contacts table to see if the email exists. And it's going to give a Boolean that says yes or no. Now, this checks to see if it exists is true. So if it exists, it's going to skip and go to the next one. And if it doesn't exist, it's going to be false and it's going to go to Zenrose. Now let's set up Zenrose. So what you need to do is you need to go and add an HTTP node like this, HTTP request, which is this. So I'm going to just delete that one. Then we're going to go to Zenrose. Now, feel free to steal this API key because I'm going to change it anyway. And so go for it. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to copy this API key. You're going to go to the HTTP node. Your method is going to be get. Your URL is api.zenrose.com/v1. No authentication. You're going to want to send query parameters using the fields below. API key is the key that we just pasted, this key right here. And URL is the URL from the Google Sheets. So item.json.website is what we're doing here, right? And no headers, no body, ignore SSL issues, and a timeout of 30 seconds. Zenrose doesn't take longer than 30 seconds to scrape a website, just so you know. And then there's some hidden settings here. If you go to the settings, you want to make sure always output data is on. Retry on fail 3 times for a wait time of 5 seconds. Now we do this just in case we hit some rate limits and stuff. And then on error, I want it to continue, so I don't want it to break, right? And on the error, we're going to a wait node, which will wait 0.5 seconds, and then it will go back to the next item on the list, right? Once we get the scraping item from Zenrose, we're going to get the body HTML. So basically we're getting data and the key body, and we're just returning the text of that, okay? Then what we're going to do is we're going to clean it with a little bit of regex. Now, I'm not going to explain regex for you, but I'm going to say if the item exists, then run this regex. And this regex basically is replacing HTML tags with nothing, so it strips out the text from the actual object. Now, another thing you could do instead of doing that is you can use the auto parse. Now, I'm not using the auto parse on Zenrose just because I don't like it, but you guys can use that if you'd like to and skip this step, actually, and just skip these 2 steps right here, right? Then I'm basically just checking to see if this and this exists within it, just to make sure that the content is good. And if it's not good, we're going to go to the next item. If it is good, I'm going to format the fields. Now, at this point, if you're only using Google Sheets and you don't have a database, all you have to do is add one column at the very end of your sheet here that says scrape. You would go like this. You would go Sheets, Google Sheets. You would append or update row. Just update your own sheet like this. Bam. And then you'd select the credential. You'd select the right sheet from list warehouses. You can either map each column manually, go column to match on email, and you can pull the email into here, and then just go all the way down to personalization, which is the last column here. Scrape. Yeah, scrape, sorry. And pull it there. And it'll auto update. So I'll actually do this for you and show you what that looks like. So we're going to run this here too. And then if not, it'll go to our database. So this will go to our sheet, and then it'll go all the way back to loop over items like that. Like that. And then also on this sheet, what we're going to do is we're going to put settings, retry on fail 3 times with 1 second. And then on error, Just continue because it doesn't really matter. It's going to go to the next item anyway. Okay? So now I'm actually going to run a test. I'm going to disconnect these nodes here. And I'm going to show you guys how this would work just with the Google Sheet. And then after that, I'll show you what it looks like with the database. Okay? So I'm actually, let's test the workflow. It's going to break right here. So we'll just test it. It's grabbing it all from the sheet. It's looping through the items. Now it's scraping. And then it goes. And it's actually just still going. But now we can see the data, right? So obviously it erred. That's fine. Here's how we're going to hook it up. So we're going to go all the way back to loop over items. We're going to grab this email and we're going to drop it here. Okay. Then we're going to scroll all the way down to scrape. And we're going to go down to if good data. And we're going to get content right here, which still has some HTML inside of it. But that's okay. We removed a lot of it. So we're going to grab the scrape here. Bam. Now, it's okay. It has some HTML because the AI can sort through it. We just want to get rid of the massive part of the code. And that already got rid of a good portion of the code. So that's good. So we're just going to drag that there. Drop that there. I just want to check clean content. Yeah, it's the same. Cool. And then we're going to go ahead and go back to Canvas. Save this. Let's test the workflow again. And I'll show you that it does update the Google Sheets. So we just got three. Let's do three more. We'll do six. Cool. Then we go over to warehouses. And you can see the scrape text showed up in the sheets right here, which is beautiful. Now that's cool, but I'm not going to use this. So I'm actually going to delete this. And I'm going to show you how to do it in the database sense, which ends up just being almost the same. So what we're going to do is we're going to, if good data is true, we're not going to loop back. If good data is true, we're going to go to edit fields, right? Here what I'm doing is I'm just mapping all of the data from all the different fields directly. Web text. Now all of these match the columns in my Supabase. So my Supabase looks like this, okay? So these columns need to be exactly the same, all right? So here on the edit fields node, I've got the columns the same and I've got the content the same here, right? So after that, we do have to add one more thing. And what this is doing is this is taking any empty strings and turning them into null values, because sometimes when you try to insert an empty string into an integer field, you'll get an error or something like that. For example, here on the Supabase, we have like total funding, which is a number. And if it tries to enter an empty string, it'll error. So we want it to just enter null instead. So that's what this JavaScript is doing here. And then that goes straight into the Supabase. So if I just hit go, test workflow, this should just run and execute the whole list into my database as we're talking, and it seems to be working just fine. We'll just double check this node real quick. I will blur out the data. But yeah, it looks like it's working just fine, inserting them into the database. So I hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. And please stay tuned for the next video of the mini series where I show you guys how to do AI personalized outreach at scale to generate massive leads for your business. Enjoy.